Hey everyone, Michael Antonovich with Swap Moto Live. The Monster Energy Supercross Championship has made the quick trip from Lucas Oil Stadium to Ford Field for Round 10, the 2023 Detroit Supercross. The series continues to tear through the calendar, as this weekend will put us into the back half of the season and wrap up a 7-race run for competitors in the 250 East Coast region. Momentum and points have been hot topics for the past month, and after a wild night in Indianapolis, both now seem to be in Cooper Webb's favor. 2 wins, 5 podiums, and 9 top 5 finishes in just as many rounds have put the Red Bull KTM rider at the top of the championship standings. Webb has a 1-point advantage over Eli Tomac and 14 on Chase Sexton, as well as the red plate, going into tonight's race. Eli Tomac has an explanation for the 8th place finish at Indianapolis. A strained neck kept the Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha rider from being able to turn his head to the right, and it affected his balance and coordination on the technical track. We'll let Eli explain it later in the video and instead focus on his record at Ford Field, which is impressive. Tomac has won 4 of the 9 450 main events held at the downtown stadium, in 2015 with Honda, in 2017 and 2019 with Kawasaki, and in 2022 with Yamaha. Continuing the streak would be massive, as it would be the 50th main event win of his career and would put him back in control of the championship. The pre-entry list for Detroit looks a little light, especially compared to past weeks. 52 racers have signed up for the 250 East Coast region, which will be enough to need A, B, and C groups in time qualifying. That's not the case in the 450 class though, as injuries and other events have drained some of the talent pool, and only 39 riders have submitted their forms to the AMA. Unless something changes, all of them will be part of the night show. The Detroit track will hold up much better than Indianapolis. The dirt has been inside the building for a while, thanks to a Monster Jam event that was here last weekend, and it's been shaped into a 10-lane layout that features a field-length rhythm section, another slightly smaller combo line, big rounded whoops, a few switchback turns with banked berms, and some tight spots that could add to the lap times. As always, here's how riders are ranked in the championship standings. In the 450 class, Cooper Webb leads with 202 points, Eli Tomac is second with 201, and Chase Sexton is third with 189. Jason Anderson is fourth with 166, Ken Roczen fifth with 164, Justin Barcia sixth with 155, Aaron Plessinger 7th with 154, Christian Craig 8th with 119, Dean Wilson 9th with 93, and Adam Cincirillo 10th with 92. Hunter Lawrence remains at the top in the 250 East Coast region with 125 points. Max Anstey is 2nd with 103, Nate Thrasher 3rd with 93, Jordan Smith 4th with 92, Hayden Deegan and Jeremy Martin are tied for 5th with 90 points each, Chris Blos is 7th with 70, Tom Vial is 8th with 68, Chance Hymus 9th with 60, and Cody Schock 10th with 57. All right, hometown guy, just tell me an hour and a half from here, and then you got to spend the week up here, so how's it been?
Good. I mean, can't complain being home, being able to sleep in my bed this week, so that was really nice. I've been down in Florida and, you know, running out of the camper, so nice to be home and eating some good meals from mom and just being in the home environment, you know, seeing friends and stuff, so wish it could have been a little bit better, though. I got sick right after Daytona, so got it from dad. He got some pneumonia, so been dealing with that, but we're feeling better this weekend, and I'm really excited for Detroit. It's my hometown race and rookie season, so I've always dreamed of racing here, and being under these lights are cool for sure.
Dude, that's got to be a trip to wake up in your bed and then roll down here. I mean, that's like every middle school kid's dream.
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, especially, man, all the Supercrosses I've watched here as a little kid, like 4 or 5 years old, coming here, and even for, you know, Detroit Lions football games, just everything. So it's cool to be able to just drive here and be on the floor and be doing this as a pro. So it's cool.
How's it been at Florida at Luke's place?
It's been awesome. It's been really great. I've been loving it there. The weather's been awesome. And yeah, we've had a good program going down there. Me, Jeremy Hand, Quinn Amiot, he's out of Canada. He's been riding a little Supercross. So been us three guys, and he's had a good program there. And I've been really loving it. My prep was a little bit shorter than I wanted to. I started kind of very beginning of January, so not as long as I wanted. But it's been great since I've been there.
All right, looking at the logo on the jersey, you got a big one right there. And I know that's been like the big joke of a sponsor and everything like that. But yeah. I heard today that you got asked about it for the local news and you had this great answer for it. So give it to me again. What is it right now for people that have this perception of OnlyFans and what they're trying to do through motocross with you?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, everybody knows what it's known for now. And you know, it's unfortunate. But, you know, like they told me and when I talked to them, you know, it's originally supposed to be for athletes and celebrities behind the scenes, you know, to follow their life, what they're doing, you know, and that's what it was created for and meant to be, a social media platform to follow athletes. So they're trying to get it back to that. And, you know, they've been signing athletes in a variety of sports, from UFC fighters, Formula One drivers, you know, different race car drivers, motocross riders, you know, helping out me, Logan, Bubba. So, you know, it's cool for sure. And I guess try to start something different, and, you know, hopefully it catches on. But, you know, it seems like OF taking over moto.
All right, if anybody subscribes to you, what kind of content's on there that they can follow?
Yeah, I've been posting kind of just, you know, keeping it moto stuff behind the scenes, though. You know, I post, like, workout things on there, more behind-the-scenes riding stuff, you know, more vlog stuff throughout the week, riding, and just things we go through, you know, throughout our day, like our schedule, you know, riding, doing our motos, our different sprints, you know, stuff from Luke. So I try to keep it, you know, different from my Instagram with more kind of exclusive stuff, but still all moto.
Question you're going to get asked a million times, so we just got to do it now. Can you give us your take on what happened last weekend and what's the outlook when the race is going that way and where your head goes to?
Yeah, Indy was tough. It was not good by any means. I didn't say anything to anyone, but I was dealing with a neck strain, as ridiculous as it sounds. And I guess it doesn't sound ridiculous, but my neck was jacked. I woke up Friday morning and I could barely look to the right. And then the thing just didn't get any better. I did as much as I could Saturday, like the PT and stuff, to try to get it better. But dude, with Supercross and that sticky dirt with all those ruts, it was really hard. Like my balance is off. I couldn't get through the whoops at all. So I'm feeling better. It's actually still not even 100%. I don't know what's going on, but that was the reason. Jacked up neck.
Okay, so then when days like this happen, and like you know they're going to happen, and a normal person knows, like, hey man, everybody has an off day, does it get frustrating for you when everybody's just expecting perfection right now? Or are you just like, yo, people, come on, I'm human still?
Yeah, if I didn't have anything like what happened, like my neck was fine, I just did that, yeah, I would be questioning it. But I don't know, man. Like when I have a result like that, I honestly don't listen to anything. I just go back home, do my thing.
Yeah. And I mean, perfect place for you guys to go now to be back in Colorado.
Yep.
Kind of finally breaking free, and you can just hone in on what you got to do.
Yeah.
Especially with what's coming up in these next few races, huh?
Yeah. With that being said, though, let's have to see how it goes. So, still happy with where I'm at. Sucks to lose the red plate, but we're right there, so we'll be fine.
All right, last thing, these next few tracks that are coming up, you know, we're in the halfway part of the schedule now, but then Seattle comes, and then we go to Arizona much, much later in the year, so big, open, hard-packed track. Then Nashville, which has been a while since we've been there, New Jersey. A lot of good elements coming up. What's your thoughts on what lies ahead?
Well, there's a mix of everything. Like you said, we have rutted tracks coming, we have hard-packed tracks coming, so I don't think there's really an advantage to anyone at this point. That's my thought. You still got to be the best well-rounded rider to finish off the series.
Devin, you're making a name for yourself here in Supercross. It's been a good few years, so how has it been to pick it up and learn it week by week?
Yeah, it's been good. Honestly, last year wasn't so good. I had a bit of a struggling few months of Supercross, I'd say, and then I ended it with a concussion and took a good like 6 or 7 months off until like late October. I started back riding, getting ready for Supercross this year. So far it's been good. I've had a few good races, then a few bad ones. Like being on the ground in the first turn is not ideal, obviously, but just keep working to be better and have a great team behind me, so just keep on working.
All right, local guy, how far is this one?
I grew up in like Terre Haute, Indiana, so this one's about like 4.5 hours for me.
Oh, so last week was home.
Yeah, last week was home.
45 yeah. minutes.
Yeah. 45 minutes, literally, yeah. So got to stay with my grandparents. We don't have a house there no longer, so I'm based out of North Carolina pretty much with my parents. And, still got to see a bunch of my family last week. And even this week, my sister lives 45 minutes from here, so it's cool to be around them. And,
Terre Haute Action Track. Did you ever go to that?
I haven't. Never been there.
I haven't either. I've always heard about it. So really? I didn't know if, like, the locals. The one thing I always think about when Terre Haute, when Ironman National, they have that big diesel and dually truck thing.
Yeah. It's all close. Like you said, Ironman's closed. Indianapolis is close. Pretty much go there twice a year, and it's for Ironman or for Indianapolis. So It's cool to be there.
That's cool. How is it to race in your home environment like that, even back-to-back weeks like this, where you know pretty familiar stuff and it's not the big grind of like waking up in a hotel and being totally out of your sorts?
Yeah, it's pretty cool, honestly. Like, I got a, both of my sisters had kids this past few years, so finally got to, you know, be the uncle and see the nephews and stuff, and so that was cool. And then, yeah, like you said, it's just awesome to be around the family, and I grew up around them, and the past couple of years I haven't been around them as much, just racing and stuff and being in a different state, so yeah, it was cool.
Hey, it's been cool to see you putting this together these last couple of years. I remember seeing you at Loretta's the first time I went, and the hair was hanging out the back, and your O'Neill guy on a Yamaha, and then the bike broke, and I remember you pushing it back, and I'm like, dude, that kid rips.
Yeah.
Like, he's got good style. So it's been cool to watch you these last couple of years.
Yeah, thank you. I really appreciate it. Heck yeah.
For sure. Thanks,
Dad. Yeah, the first thing is, like, we want Baba, you know, like, fully recovery. We want him to come back. And yeah, I was just, like, I was in the hospital with him on Sunday, and, yeah, they needed a rider, so he asked me, and everything worked out. So, yeah, I'm really happy, you know, to back home and back to the team. I'm just riding Baba's bike, so bike is awesome. This year they have like too many different things compared to the other years, and it's amazing. So yeah, you know, happy to be back, and I'm even riding all his stuff, you know, like, look, even his helmet, so his goggles, everything. So yeah,
I'm so bummed for him, because he's like right there, and he's been doing such a good job these last couple years to get that team going where it needs to be, and that Instagram post is brutal. So how was he at the hospital this week? Seemed like he had a smile on his face.
Yeah, honestly, that, you know, I know Baba really well, and I was a little surprised when I went to see him, because he was pretty good. I would be pissed, and he normally too, and he was like super kind of happy and take it easy, you know, it's what it is, you can do anything. So yeah, really happy that he took it on that way, and yeah, he was doing a really good job the last weeks too, and trying to make his bike on the mend. So yeah, pumped for that. But you know, from all the bad things, sometimes it come good things, and I hope, you know, we can bring good results to the team. I didn't make finally the main last week again, so yeah, let's have fun.
Okay, like you said at the start, you've been with these guys before. You've seen it come and go, really grow these last couple years.
Mm-hmm.
How different is it from these last time you rode it, and what's been the biggest progress?
I think every year the team grew up, you know. They started like in 17, I think, with Michael Akadin and him, and like teammates, partners, and he grew like crazy. We started to have three bikes, 3450 bikes, you know, like 1-250 bike in top 10s. We make 450 main, so the team started to grow like crazy. And I think this year is the biggest progress and the biggest change. You know, obviously they have, I think, like way better parts and products for the bike. And obviously, you know, they have like that big rig, the Matt Parts guy, you know, Jonas Borg, Matt Parts guy, they're doing like an awesome job, an awesome push for the team. And you know, like I said, I'm just new from this week, so I don't know like all the things from this year, but they look so good. The bike is so good. I did ride at Baba's track like Tuesday and Wednesday, and the bike was awesome, and I was feeling really good. So yeah, I'm looking for having, you know, a fun weekend.
New guy on the bike, second week with him. How's it been getting a fill-in rider for Carter Bees?
Guillaume has been absolutely fantastic. I mean, he adapted to the motorcycle immediately. He was on the 350, so not a huge adjustment from his last package to this. We took his MX Tech suspension and strapped it onto this bike. So there really hasn't been much of a transition other than power. But I mean, he's such a talented rider, and he was able to adapt to it. Absolutely. I mean, a light switch adaptation. He got about 20 minutes on the bike at the first race that he was on, where he got to ride Preste. But I mean, since then he's been, you know, been a dream to work with, and he's great with the fans, and he's very personable, and I mean, I have nothing but positive. He's very, very easy to get along with. His girlfriend Anna is fantastic. She's his mechanic. I mean, she was on me about putting gas on the bike and lubing the chain and stuff, which, I mean, you know, they're in a new environment, so she's just, you know, trying to manage, you know, what she can. And what's funny is she doesn't speak much English, and still she was on me. And we haven't gotten to the point to where we've had to use Google Translate, but, you know, Guillaume, he speaks perfect English compared to most motocross racers. Yeah.
As a second language.
Yeah, English is a second language. He's from Victoriaville, Quebec.
Okay.
I think that's the name of the town.
I was, you know, all these things, like, how do you find that guy? Because even the first time that I saw his name on the results sheet, I was just like, all right, well, how do you say that name? And then I heard somebody say it, I'm like, oh, French Canadian, makes sense now.
Yeah. So it's like the phonetic of it would be Giuliani. But it's Gi Ohm, which is it's like Gi butter and then Ohm, the measurement of electricity.
There you go.
But how I found him was whenever I was in Daytona on Friday, Carter called me and was like, dude, you know, I'm out. And so I pulled up all the PDFs from the last couple races, and I was like, okay, who's racing? Who's on KTMs? Who's making it into the night show? And additionally, who's on 23s? And going through that list, I mean, you know, you start with in the 250 class, I mean, it's Tom Vial, the Rides Unlimited guys, and then the occasional TPJ guy like Saunier, and then there's a couple other dudes, Blaise Grimaldi, and a couple other dudes. And like, they're not putting up the results, those privateer guys are, but like the rides guys, everybody was signed that was riding KTMs. And so, I mean, it was very slim pickings. As a matter of fact, 10 minutes after I went through that process and saw that Guillaume was racing and riding at 23 and had made the night show in Houston, I was like, okay, this is my guy. As soon as I see him, I'm gonna say something. 10 minutes later, he walks past the garage in Daytona. I was like, hey, how do you say your name? He comes up to me. He was like, Guillaume. And I was like, okay. Went straight over my head. But it was a very quick adaptation between the two of us. And we get along very well. And I'm thrilled to have him here.
All right. Last thing. Made the bikes look different every week. Even through Arena Cross, a lot of different color schemes and graphics packages. As a designer at heart, how is it to come up with this stuff? And then how is it to make each sponsor have their own standout thing every week?
Well, it's actually kind of, it's a very fun process. So, you know, I mean, even though I am the team owner and the team manager, I'm also the graphics guy for the team. That's my favorite part of the job. I really don't enjoy working on the bikes. I'm going to give both Guillaume and Cheyenne like 100% effort when it comes to working on the bikes. But doing graphics is what I want to be doing, is doing the social, doing the digital, that kind of stuff. But yeah, we have a different feature partner every weekend, a new livery every weekend, and it's been, I mean, it's so fun because guys are coming up and they're like, hey, who are you riding for this week? Oh, dude, it's still Ribbon Rod Cycles on KTM. But yeah, this weekend it's ODI, last weekend it was Bellray, and then in Detroit it was the ODMC, which is Old Dude Moto Crew, which is a Facebook group of moto guys that are all over 40, and they sponsored us for that weekend. But yeah, moving forward, it'll be a different company, different sponsor. I'm saying the word sponsor because that's what most people say, but to me they're partners. Without them we wouldn't be here. But yeah, it's something fresh. Like to keep it new and we like to keep the people guessing.
It's been fun to watch you in this team manager role, look up in the manager's tower every week, see you calling the shots up there, see the bikes get better week after week. So how's it been?
So far 2023 has been, I would say, spectacular for us. You know, coming in with Max, we're going to call him a rookie in the 250 class. Not necessarily, he's more of a veteran, but you know, I believe that from the moment we started talking about him, we could do something special, you know, and try and bring him up to where he deserves to be. And it's been a work process for me. It's been challenging with a motorcycle, just bringing everything in-house. I have a great group of people, Firepower Honda Racing, everybody behind it is just, I call it, you know, homemade hard work is what we do there. You know, under our building is not spectacular, but we are very happy to have what we have. And we're proud and we take a lot of pride into it. And we want to keep doing what we're doing. I think we're sitting in a great spot. You know, we do want to get the win. You know, sometimes we need to, you know, check back and really start looking at the bigger picture and seeing how far we've come. So. Me as a manager now, I'm just learning a lot more, learning about myself, calling the shots, like you're saying, having to make the right decisions. And at the end of the day, the priority for me is to provide the best that we can provide to the riders so they can do their job.
The technical knowledge that you have about bikes and what you've been able to put into both bikes, 250s and the 450s, it's impressive, Martin. Like, I know you get it, and to see what you're able to relay to guys, I mean, that's years and years and years of being in it at the highest level.
Yeah, I think so, and I'm thankful that you know, God has blessed me with the talent of riding a motorcycle, and I've learned a lot throughout the years riding for, you know, from riding for Mitch, you know, KTM, all these factory teams that I've learned. I've gathered a lot of information, and I still ride, I still test, I feel what these guys are feeling, which that is the most important thing. When a rider comes back and tells me, hey Marty, this is something that I'm feeling, like, can you please double check? So I'm able to, you know, sometimes I'm able to tell them, hey, you know, maybe we need to go in a different direction. Maybe, yes, you're right, we need to change it up, see how we can make it better. So it's been fun for me, a challenge, obviously, to get so involved in the motorcycle. I feel like I'm very involved. I love it. I really do love it. I love seeing these riders achieve their goals. You know, that's what I put myself in their shoes, and that's what I would want from somebody that is trying to help me. You know, just trying to help me reach my goals and trying to help me, you know, live my dream. And that's what I'm trying to do for them, and also doing it myself. You know, it is a lot of effort and time away from my family, but you know, they're proud of me. We've come a long way, and I feel like it's awesome to see.